Ready, bub? You'll say slurp there?
Okay. Yep.
Alright.
almost. Okay, yep. We are recording. We are good to go.
Cool. Not fill the 1 AC before.
Alright,
so.
Good luck, y'all.
Thanks.
Alright, ready, Bob?
Yep.
One, oppression is bad for equality. A, arbitrariness. Identity is morally arbitrary, so allowing discrimination undermines the foundation of moral theory. B, inclusion is a epistemological prerequisite. Oppression, the biggest impact, so you can't form moral theories until those affected are included by C. Any theory that condones an equal society or should be rejected, so would not be accepted by those at the bottom. That makes it useless political philosophy, which must be justified by the citizen who government was over. Second, equity was assumed in a starting position of equality grounded through works. If everyone could engage in ethics, starting point is flawed. Fifth, their justification taken with unequal society order, they should be rectifying these inequalities into prerequisite ethical justification. Third, abstract liberalism is proposed to maintain status quo. Oppression only activists to solve other ethics only serve the patient's power. And Peninsula, civil six, explains the example of the racist ideology to powerful. Essentially, reinforcement of the status quo dominant from inside the fact that the racial exclusion were all part of the same movement. Abstract liberalism, policy, liberalism, and abstract freedom explain racial matters. Why it's going to be reasonable while posing a person's deal with inequality continues as a tender. They're going to intervene as little as possible. That change should happen through so evolution process rather than government action. Just fine, keeping the fairest way they are. The right behind the line of the choice. They see something that all groups have the same power because whites have more power of the choice. We reproduce white supremacy. And for the topic, concerns the conflict between two types of violation. The question is which one is worse. Affirmer must be able to weigh impacts and pressure. Should be a relevant factor in the affirmer calls. You should reject this. Assess inequality is impacted wisely. The most fundamental requirements of an ethical theory. Any conflicts default to repression since A. Certain groups have been marginalized for a long time. So correcting this ensures the possibility for future change or advertising. Other violations of laws of marginalization continue to definitely be inequalities, especially repugnant regardless of the harm caused the fact that people are being penal. Means one person should be harmed for the sake of collective sea marginalization. Pills are impacts of other types of violations, restriction, free speech. Little conclusion, democratic vitality, so stronger like the other stance than the other offense. And five, traditional ideas of democracy, form inclusion, negative rights, or exclusion, and making deliberate process illegitimate until we transform that's young. And one. In a society structured by inequality, forming the inclusive process, and act structured by some which powerful actors are created, actually deliver the process, dominant preceding citizen, who criticize the public deliberation, we even have a lot of the form of the worst, except the structural inequalities, restrict actions, for conclusion, they're not legitimate, they should speak on behalf of those excluded, and specifically, heteronormative power structures are exclusionary, and problematized social democracy, as feral, and for heteronormative, means that must be hidden only for the males and others, only for females, individuals not fit or made visible status, heteronormative practices, black access, full political social participation for billions of individuals, and democratic exclusion ideology, defines a fundamental mission. Six, an accurate epistemology, scale, otherwise, affirmative quality, bias, making self defeating, a better epistemological standpoint, is prerequisite, accurate ethical deliberation, the dominant standpoint, requires meaningful discussion. Primarily subtracting to work, suppression, examining ethical problems with the oppressors, either Jagger and 83 standpoint, they provide some right to view and rally more impartial than the ruling class to you. Condition the oppressor, invisible dimly, the ruling class, the oppressor, able to see the fail, and rule the rules standpoint, the oppressor, standpoint with the ruling class. And thus, the standard is resisting oppression. And oppression necessarily, the group primarily constitutes harmful actions, group because there are certain groups as peers. And 10. Action of the group cannot be to produce the action of individual members that join the action broken out of the central element of the loss of coordination of action groups, and also the object harm which is attacking the group of the individual victim, but oppression must be understood the group harm if the individual is oppressed to the virtue of being a member of the group, while oppression is usually then harm loses according to value. Contention. Trans youth are targets of discrimination among us, Carol. Teacher participate in harassment, youth come out of trans parents often kick about, experience how the ones cost without support, these feelings of isolation more than half of all trans youth attempt to kill themselves, and denied access to performance to say the cost of suicidal tendencies, Carol. Research found that depression, suicide, alcohol, and trans people outside the unmade need for gender conforming, that cures denying access to performance represents a refusal to recognize humanity, trans people, frustration, or ability to. Self-determining differences on autonomy as discrimination from treatment has been shown to alleviate oppression, reducing the risk of suicide in transgender youth, and lack of control over their own bodies leads trans adolescents to legally get access to therapy that's cure. Trans youth seeking access to hormones that counter number three of some taking hormones and sources other medical professionals, thus maybe a poor quality or dosage work, they may be taking reuse effects of needles, hormones create the potential for serious health problems and a brain refrain. Thus the plan. Governments should ensure that adolescents have the right to make autonomous medical choices regarding hormone suppression therapy. I reserve the right to clarify CX for issues of specification topicality. There are four things that the often specify multiple different avenues for the resolution, especially when I don't know the one is each having to come into the round CX tracks. He to run to XP to T debates every round to clarify, drop the argument on all topicality and theory arguments that are checked since we asked for the two things. And personal consent is insufficient for trans people. The measure of adoption establishes a presumption allowing treatment for trans adolescents leads to spill over trans adolescent medical rights. Care. Parents of trans youth are often abusive or absent. This makes it difficult for adolescents to transition with lead to medical care. Trans youth may overcome the law through measure of adoption. Except for parental consent, the adoption allows treatment if the use is mature enough to appreciate the consequences of the action doctrine. Allows monitoring consent to treatment without permission for the court. Reducing legal scrutiny could encourage medical clinics to provide their treatment protocols. And parental consent influence can guilt adolescents into gender conformity. Colon. Before interventions are considered, adolescent exploration family should be undertaken. And adolescents toward gender conformity can occur to please parent physical interventions, one fully reversible interventions, two generation dialogues, suppress estrogen or testosterone, continue contraception, suppress menses, and cut the credit fancies, and puberty suppressive hormones reaffirm fluid conceptions of identity. Comment. Adolescent may be eligible for puberty suppressive hormones as soon as the parent still changes the vegan hormones, thus giving the adolescent more time to include their gender nonconformity and facilitate transition by preventing the development of sexual restriction that is impossible to reverse if the adolescent continues to undergo sexual reassignment. And use of puberty suppressive hormones during adolescence can reverse social backlash against trans individuals. Comment. Early use of puberty suppressive hormones for a negative social emotional consequence of gender dysphoria more effectively than they use when functioning and later life can be compromised by the development of irreversible sex during puberty. And refusing treatment for gender adolescence has emotional consequences. Comment. refusing treatment for adolescents, my prolonged abuse and stigmatization, gender-related abuse, strong system with psychiatric accessory and adolescents with the health of human suppression, or mother therapy is not an option. Improv percentage is just another group that trans adolescents have to jump through. Carol. Transgender youth who seek access to hormone counter barriers to express their gender identity, parents of trans youth are often hospital abuse in some states, immature medical doctors, laws, physicians, pride, medical services, outpatient extent, and the presumption for adolescent decision-making capability flips from the criminal justice context to transgender medical context. Carol. The government's parents preach we have responsibility to protect youth from harm, and context trans youth seeking access to hormones can mount to force trans adolescents down a particular path may involve a great deal of unnecessary summary, and a presumption in favor of access to hormones would be a safeguard against prejudice that the easy way sound, but just about providing services to trans youth. Carol. A presumption in favor of allowing trans adolescents to retain hormones without parental consent, but mitigate persons to trans youth require the party opposing access to prejudice use immaturity, making less likely that access would be denied. Presumption in favor would also be sure medical professionals not providing services not exposed to legal liability. First interview. 1. Prefer reasonable after terms and drop the card, but I see the judge sees reasonability with the bright line of the presence of Lincoln Bachelor and ground for the negative sense he has equal access to officers to speech because structured access to the ballot state. A. There are multiple legitimate interpretations of the topic of the applicants with ground with no knowledge of the one to see strategy. I just choose between usually exclusive interests and neck can always be teased, so don't punch me for having set grounds. 2. After starting eyes, 8 times Q, the chariot is not enough time to cover both theory and substance to 2 and R, twice as long as I have half the opposite of the end of round. I should be able to collapse to the highest layer, empirically proven by the last time you judge me. B, the 1 year is too short to be theory, especially 5 to cover his shell. I need an RBI theory to be able to reciprocal, which is key to equal access to the balance. C, the opposite always been a theory, since I have to take a stance on separate interpretation of the issues. RBIs are key to check for the theory, key to discussion of the topic, which is key to education, and ensures the opposite access to the 1AC. D, only the negative BT, which accrues theory, and off opposite, so I need an RBI for an order to compensate for me that advantage. Second, the negative, the also, and the negative must check all crossing, all theory interpretation, all theory tropicality interpretation cross examination, key to avoiding theory. Bay cross apply the warrant from above. If we don't want to have through education because it's bankrupt, specifically in terms of the 1AC, coupled with times, you mean it's irreversible. Third, link of a fourth, link of omissions. Drop the argument on link of omissions. There are infinite things that the 1AC could have talked about, but I did not. I take a one stance on interpretation of issues in order to put us in the right direction, which is always going to be not beneficial. Otherwise, we just debate about things that I didn't talk about, which is nonsensical, rather than you should criticize the things that I did talk about. And active resistance doesn't make any sense because I was not actively resisting against something, I was just in support of one ideology.
Like the stuff you accepted at the bottom that wasn't in the
AC? There were two arguments. One was a CX checks for everything, just to clarify. Okay. And then the
for like theory and topicality?
Theory and topicality.
Okay.
And then the one? Last argument was link drop the argument on links of omission.
What's a link of omission?
Link of omission is saying that there is something either like there are different ways this can be framed, and I'd argue that the judge should use the spirit in case you're like being sketch. So essentially an argument that would say the affirmative did not talk about something. So that is bad, or that the affirmative is a passive silence against
right,
something.
Okay, so your plan says that adolescents should have the right, but you don't you only specify a right, but you don't specify an age, race, or class, or like anything of adolescents. I just want to clarify that you defend this for all adolescents.
I defend it for all adolescents.
Okay, what is an adolescent?
An adolescent? I mean, the 1AC does not have a definition of that. If this is a theory violation, or
it's not a theory violation.
Or a critique link, I do not have a like right there. Like the thing is that the like definition of adolescent is so broad and varied,
just
right? Anyone who's,
definition.
I mean, I'm not gonna like, I don't think I have to like bind myself into a definition. Like the way some of the, you could read one, but like the way most of the topic literature would define an adolescent is someone who like is going through puberty, or someone who is like they've said physically maturing but not fully mentally mature.
Okay, do you define the app for non-human adolescents?
For non-human adolescents, yeah.
You do? Mm-hmm. Okay, how did they get access to
I mean, I didn't say that they, like, necessarily have the ability, like, right, the, like...
So, do you defend the app for them? Explain to me how. Explain to me where you do that in the app.
Well, it's just that they have to have a right to make autonomous medical choices, right? Like, there's nothing that says that a beaver. There's nothing that says. Saavan, there's nothing that says a beaver. There's nothing that says a beaver does not have the right to buy a Ferrari if it really wanted to.
Just explain to me how a non-human animal has access to hormone therapy.
I mean,
how do you defend your app for non-human adolescents?
I mean, I'd argue that it's not going to be like as effective, but I mean, honestly,
just explain me how you defend it for non-human adolescents at all.
Well,
in any way or form.
Sure, any of the hormone blockers that we use, like non-human animals aren't any different. They like have testosterone and like estrogen, like they're similar to humans, which would mean the same hormone blockers probably would still work in animals. Like if an animal was exhibiting a desire to conform with the opposite gender.
The app must defend the general principle that adolescents have to have the right to make autonomous medical choices without specification.
What do you mean by like? What do you mean by like a general principle? I can't spec.
Yes.
Is this like a nevel to your argument, like bare plural, or
just will you make the interpretation?
I need the interpretation?
Yep. I'm CX checking right now.
Oh, wait. Okay.
So yes or no?
I will violate.
Okay. How much CX time do I have left?
12.
Okay. So all of your oppression evidence indicates that we should stop, like, human oppression, we should look to, like, citizens and stuff like that.
What is the status of the non-human animal in your grammar?
Okay. Sorry. Can you rephrase?
What's the status of the non-human animal in your framework?
I don't know what the status of the non-human animal
is. Is it equal? Or non-human animals equal to humans in your framework? Simple question.
I say we should resist oppression. I say that we should resist the framing in the AF talks about heteronormative power structures.
Cool. 2:54. I'm gonna flash you.
2:54 left?
Yep.
Okay. How many off?
Order's gonna be 3 off case.
Do you have like a phone by any chance, Saavan?
Yeah.
I kind of like to see your time during your speech. Would you mind using your phone?
My phone like turns off that.
You have a timer?
Yeah. Can I use this for my speech? If he gives you a timer.
Oh, I thought he was going
to give you a timer. This won't turn off during my speech, right?
There's also a timer on verbatim.
Like it won't lock?
No, it won't. Unless you just like don't touch it.
Okay, cool. Is everyone ready?
3 after this.
Yep.
Aids the interpretation, the aphemus defend the general principle that adolescents ought to have the right to make autonomous medical choices without specification. Clarify, you can read specific medical choices such as hormone suppression as advantage to the gap. You cannot just defend a specific medical choice or specific subsection adolescent violation. They defend the specific medical choice of hormone suppression only. Net benefits, one, they don't textually from the resolution. Two, reasons they support the word the is an indefinite article, meaning you can't defend a parameterized plan. For example, I wouldn't say I want the right to X as a general principle if I only really want it in one specific instance. I would say I want a right to X as a general, I would want a right to medical choice. the reference dictionary finds the as used marking noun as being used generically, B, supporting the bare plural of adolescence and medical choices is generic as opposed to existential, meaning that you do not specify specific medical choices, or but rather defend them in general. No one logically knows a plan involving only single medical choices. If someone believes medical choice should be given to adolescents, they will not say adolescents ought to have medical choices, but rather deny this claim and say that hormone suppression is the exception. Even 14. Bare plural is like determiners. Consider some examples. One debater, two debaters, small one debater seems to go with some debaters, and two debaters seems to refer to debaters in general. The use of bare plural is generic. Generic reasons correct. The best evidence for this is the unassured judgment is ordinary speakers. The existential interpretation is knowledgeable, so pragmatic benefits are relevant to impacts. A, the semantic interpretation is incorrect, so pragmatic benefits are relevant. Even if your interpretation might be good for today, the topic doesn't allow me that you can object to the talk committee, but your counterinterpret has no merit in evil 15. The topicality rule just applies to semantic approach. You beyond fair to expect the negative to prepare against anything other than the resolution, because that is the only mutual acceptable way to describe the educational benefits that you need to base them from class focused on proposition term. Be foreign pragmatic considerations or reasons to change the topic. B, limits go over limit or shaking the debate to one issue. There are literally thousands of medical choices that exist, which creates muscle research burns in the neck, whereas the app knows exactly what Rachel's little said, yeah, that ways, but that's impossible to achieve. Clash never occurs here. 13. The limits debate has real consequences. I could be getting there, tried against any random argument, but there are only so many nice days. I would like to play catch or go to movie. Roller, infinite firm, says the community doesn't care whether participants have life or spend time with their family. Limits are real impact because I feel their impact every day. And 3. Ground general, this hasn't applied because they assume the app happens to everyone. Also, topic glitch always slows out because very few others will talk about why the plan is bad for specific medical choices only in general. This means they don't have access to wide body offense, which gives them a structural advantage. Reciprocity is key defense, so you can access the bot. Also, a topical version of the app would have solved all of the offense that they're making about how education and way now. The voter is fairness. You're about to ask for the better rating, which you can't evaluate upon a better structural advantage. Use committee interpretations because I don't know what you think is reasonable to do. The reasonability bright line that established in the 1AC is very arbitrary. I don't know what it means to have access to impact turns the app, which is clearly subjective. Now, drop the debater. A times Q is made adjust to disadvantage substance. B sets the precedent. The debaters can't run unfair non-topical arguments. C, no argument to drop. They should engage in practice. D, dropping them. They're absolutely functionally the same thing. No RBI is 1. The app is burden to be topical. You don't have the jurisdiction to vote off a non-topical app. RBIs don't make sense. The all these reasons are generic reasons why you get RBIs in theory doesn't apply here. And bad T should be easy to be good to response check. Time trade off. Also, it's reciprocal. You could run theory and generate offense the same letter debt. Also, RBIs have just had another little debate. The app is when they need you. When offense to GN and RBI, making it harder for a man. Chilling effect discourages checking your beats because cheap data will just prevent common interests. Next up. The role of the ballot is anthropocentrism, determining the moral standing of humanity. The affirmative resolves it positively. This culminates in extinction. It should be resolved negatively. Colbert 14. What is scandalous is not that humans have placed their own survival is more valuable than other lives, but at the heart of moral society is an assumption that nothing is more valuable or definitive of life value than human life's capacity to maintain and find itself. We ground value life or really face up the circularity. We value life because it's life that makes value possible. We value values. We seem to think that not only that value of life lies in flourishing, but that something like instruction rather than itself never unacceptable. How can humanity be once the figure that which renders itself life self evidently valuable, yet be the being that has through valuing itself and not only others its own kind? How humanity defines itself as that being that endlessly chooses to have, yeah, has only done so by saving its own life. Why is it that the increasingly shrill affirmation of life, not just human life, life is a living that furthers and values itself, occurs precisely at the moment is the history of life when it is at its most destructive, most evident end. Cut the card to end. And the presentation of the 1AC produces complacency and the very harms it's trying to avoid, because the mindset they endorse points a rosy view of the world that effaces our connection and species, balance, and non-human beings. The truth is, the adolescent subject is not wholly human, but the mindset they endorse from the AC 1AC to CX regards as asking and cross-examination whether he defended all adolescents. Since he said yes, and I asked him if he defended for non-human adolescence, he couldn't specify how the plan applies to non-human adolescence. Obviously, he was just trying to get out of link, but he could not articulate a single reason as to why the plan actually gives non-human adolescence. Don't let me say that hormone therapy applies to animals as well, because A, he hasn't given evidence as to why that's true. B, the plan only applies to governments that give it to humans. And the reality is, adolescence accepts is in a concept which extends across the non-human world from species to species. Goldman 12. Humans aren't the only animal that makes passage. And adolescent gazelles often have appeared in adolescence throughout the animal kingdom. Adolescence are reactive to gradually lose protection. The parents, young animals of any species must try to deal with adult demands, between risking safety, risking decision, or recurring feature of adolescence for species after species, including prefrontal cortices. And there's no uniqueness to survival. Good claims. Domination, internal suffering of animals is inevitable in a world of anthropocentrism. These species genocide create mass extinction in non-human populations, inevitably cause human extinction. Video 7. Species continue to severe at extinction rate 1 species per million per year. Nothing compares to the 20th century cause of extinction, habitat degradation, overexploitation, agriculture, monocultures, human born invasive species, human induced climate change. 21st century kills, haunt, kills, unchecked, and addressing accelerating battle sites. 7 to 10 biologists made that mass extinction poses a loss to human existence, and the dangers of mass extinction are woefully underestimated. And the alternative is that the judge should vote negative to reject the anthropocentrism of the 1AC. The role of the judge is to use the debate space for the practice of post-humanities as an operative displacement of anthropocentrism. Cheney 05. If we test our worldviews against those of other communities, we are far from emancipating ourselves from empirical parochialism. Our insistence that we are the knowers and the non-human world is merely the object for knowing is diminished of what we are when we engage in active reciprocal communication with the world around us. If we draw a circle around our existence, we effectively cut off our own source of existence. And active reciprocal communication with the natural world can enable us to reach the transcendent limit of the parochialism. Once we acknowledge knowledge and just participating in the construction of knowledge, it is but a short step to radically rethink our notion of knowledge and truth. And to clarify, the alt is not a policy because the K is criticism of the mindset of the app, which is why the alt has to be mindset adaptive as well. Now go to the next off.
Medical decisions cost money, but adolescents don't have any. McGuire 10. Many treatments are expensive. Like live that a parent minor is able to sustain such fees remote. Hence, there's an a priori assumption of parental approval and consent. The adolescents, well, the adult are on equal footing in this matter. And the core 10 of the app is that parents don't allow adolescents to get access to hormone therapy. But since adolescents don't have any money, they won't be able to pay for it anyway. Way 4, empirically proven, because most teens are dependent on their parents for money. Way 14, financially dependent teenagers doubles income the norm for parents pay bills for growing internet, music, and TV. Abuse already found 40% barely beginning of doing have enough money to meet the expenses. 3MX, one, not only will parents not pay for the operation, which moves solvency, but they also punish the child's form of retaliation and don't mind the
let's just get a case.
Off the visa point of inclusion, requiring the alternative is a prerequisite to having inclusion in the first place, because your form of inclusion only includes humans, which means that we must engage in the alternative to form a to create a form of knowledge that actually includes non-humans. Now, off the visa point, you say we should reject unequal theories. That's the reason we reject the affirmative, because your justification is that we need to be able to justify things to citizens. Citizens is only humans, that non-human can never enter the realm of citizens, which means that all of your oppression arguments are only oppressions for humans, not non-humans. Now, off the silver argument, turn your re-entrenching in the presidentialism, which recreates the dominant ideology in the first place. Second, the alternative is not abstract, because there's a rejection of what you did. You say we should weigh impacts, I mean, because I'm weighing the app against the critique, because it leads to extinction. Second, anthropocentrism is bad, because you say oppression is only for humanity. You quote fact that people are equal means that one group shouldn't be harmed. Now, you off the young one evidence, you say traditional inclusion is bad, but it says that citizens should contest, which precludes the access to the non-human, because the non-human can never access that. Now,
go to the RBI stuff.
You say to the 1 hour short, this is specific to theory, and it's reciprocal, because you can read theory. You also say it checks realist theory. Turn, you can read realist theory. If you get RBI, it's also empirically denied, because the topicality isn't frivolous. None of your theory, none of your RBI arguments apply to topicality.
Wait, what was that last argument?
None of your RBI arguments apply to topicality.
Okay. That's fine. Also, no RBI, I'm just gonna write this down. No RBI errors for T.
Yeah, I know what I started. What comes first, theory or the K?
What do you mean?
Like, which one does the judge evaluate first?
Like, that's like asking...
If I dropped both, would you vote on theory, or would you vote on the K?
Like, it would depend on the context of the round, wouldn't it?
Well, depend on the context of the round. Alright, I want you to choose which one comes first.
Now. Right, so this...
You have two framework agreements. You say
right,
the fairness
so,
matters,
see, the problem,
you say...
The problem with this question, because I've encountered this question like 3 times in this tournament, and
okay.
It's a really bad interpretation, is that if I say that one comes before the another, it moots half of the one NC, because you will just go for the one that I said came first, which literally destroys all of my ground.
Alright.
Like I cannot
the
1AC establish.
The 1AC made framework arguments. Couldn't the 1NC have just collapsed to the AC and had 7 minutes of turns to it?
What? Yeah, but that presumes that I was able to get turn ground in the first place, which is clearly denied given the fact that you defend a very specific plan.
All right, that assumes that. Okay, that's fine. All right.
But additionally, like, that doesn't make any sense.
All right, that's cool.
I cannot specify which one comes first without context. All right,
so you... Around. Okay, that's fine. In terms of, like, what is the status of the KL?
What do you want it to be?
I want it to be unconditional.
It's... Yeah, unconditional.
Unconditional. Okay. That's fine.
You're timing this, right?
Yeah. Well, he's timing it too.
Cool.
Then, I guess, other than that, for theory, so you make an argument. Why is, like, textuality super important?
There's multiple justifications.
Sure.
The first is that no one would logically endorse a plan involving only a single medical choice, i.e. the resolution says that adolescents ought to have the right to make medical choices, which means that a specific plan that only defends a single medical choice is logically incoherent if you're trying to affirm the resolution. There's multiple justifications for this. The first is that the best evidence for this is the undisputed judgment of ordinary speakers, i.e. no one would logically endorse this plan if they heard this. Like, if you ask someone on the street whether this statement, the statement of your affirmative, actually affirms this statement, they would say no, which means that you are not precise in affirming the resolution. Then there's multiple justifications for this semantic interpretation. The first is the topicality rule, because it would be unfair to expect the negative to pair against anything before the round if it's not the resolution, i.e. the only thing we have coming into the round is the text of the resolution in the first place. Then there's like multiple other justifications,
right,
i.e.
yeah,
if textuality is important and you want to defend a plan, that's just a reason why we should ask the committee to change the topic if you just want to debate something instead of actually just like filing the text of the resolution. And then limits are also a reason why textuality is important, because I can't spend every single night of my life preparing against specific affirmatives, because it means that I won't be able to spend time with my family or like do things in school if I'm just preparing against like
okay.
prepping out each affirmative, like affirmative for foster care home or your affirmative.
All right. 5 minutes of prep.
Did you read all six reasons for the RBI?
No, I didn't read the sixth reason.
Okay. Stop, 106. It's called 1AR-R6.
What is it?
It's called 1AR-R6. The order is, starting on, it's just T. But the order is, for the 1AC RVI arguments, you can just, like, if you want to, like, move those to the T-shell, I'll, like, answer his answers on the... Actually, we can just actually know. We'll just start on the 1AC if it is, like the RBI stuff.
I like the movement.
Oh, you want to you like that idea?
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
Wait, what are we doing?
He's gonna move my RBI arguments from the 1AC.
Oh, okay.
Right. Tell me when you have that up. I said 106. Do you agree with 106, Pop? 104, okay. Alright. This is yours. Let me know when you're ready, Bob.
Wait, so the order's T?
It's starting on RV. It's starting on the RV arguments from the AC, and then counter-interp his shot. Ready? Or it's like that whole underview, not just the RBI stuff.
Okay.
The whole, just the theory underview.
Maybe I won't lose
it. Okay, that's fine. Just go to the 1AC, that's fine. Okay.
Yep.
Extended prefer reasonable affirms to drop the argument to T. You should use reasonable with line of presence, link in a pattern graph. The negative, you're only your argument, you don't know any pattern graph. There are literally no argument to that argument. You could have literally said that the government is bad. You could have impacted in the state of Red Wilderson. If there is anything you could have done against this army that is impacted ground that you definitely have. There is no answer to the warrant of the argument because that means we still have the equal access to the balance. So the UBS is structural access to the balance. Same, no warrant. You should not let them make you competing interpretation arguments. The next piece also extend that there are multiple legitimate interpretations of topic. Africa goes to the ground with no knowledge of what's strategy. I just choose between mutually served set. You could always be T, so don't push me over to scratch. I said that Africa's RVA is ace of points time to you because I don't have enough time to cover both theory, substance, 2 hours, twice as long. So I have to have offices twice at the end of the debate. You say they're all specific to theory, but topicality is a type of theory, obviously, because you're saying that topicality isn't frivolous. No RBI arguments, that's arguable. No, topicality probably is frivolous because this isn't even topicality. You're just saying that we're not lost into the resolution means that I have to be able to gender. You're essentially just saying plan's bad with a justification of the resolution because there's still a different interpretation. For example, policy debate doesn't necessarily mean a textuality of the resolution, but you can still engage from it, especially if you think I'm winning enough defense to the RBI arguments, that's probably sufficient. But you've also conceded extend the basic point that the 1AR is too short to read theory, which answers your argument about how I could have read theory in the 1AR, and I need an RBI deferred theory to be reciprocal. 100% conceded that impacts directly to fairness, which is the voter on the show. Extend the season point. The office is always open to theory since I have to take stance on some interpretation issues. Your RBIs are key to check for this theory and key to discussion the topic, which is key to education. Ensures the Afghans access to the 1AC. Also extend the decent point that negative retrieve, which frequency and all that happens. So I need RBI to compensate for that advantage. Also, because you've conceded that I can't read theory in the 1AR, there's no answer to that argument. Now,
Fairness, topicality is a prerequisite to any form of discussion. Turns, oh, this is like fairness always decay. Turns all your impacts that's got weight. And 7, according to fairness, one was added to the other. If it denies the person who has the other back of my research critical thinking enable, here's the main dialogue opposition necessary because sharpest thought to reach agreement, which might assist with common cause to beta compensation for the experience of the world by African frame that makes things equality for the sake of the conversation. Other substitutes do not act with the agreement, the dialogical benefits of the topical advocacy. You say that you shouldn't have to specify the one error, but that is nonsense. If I want to collapse the argument set, especially in the one error of a time scale, that is exactly the reason why I only have a 4-minute one error, so that I should be able to collapse the certain arguments because otherwise I would have to answer every single argument of the one I see, which means that collapses are uniquely good. That directly impacts directly in fairness, which means that always arguments are probably preferable. Don't let them just make 6 minutes of the KR ways because then I'll be able to do that wing in the 2AR. Next, counter. AF must defend any government or group of governments and a benevolent policy that gives adolescents a right to autonomous medical choices and disclose all broken plan text and advantages. Full text on the NDC wiki, the negative may not contest the ability to run a plan. The OCI is a reason to vote for me. If my role is better excluded, my practice is bad, and they should lose for it. It sounds better norm in favor of plans which are good. Prefer one, plans are good at using empirics, which is key to clear judging. Over in 14. Neville's plan. Neville's view produces bad debates, debaters either debate through general reliability of examples of higher examples coming all together. Neither which he had protected these may be difficult to judge through lack of standard example comparison. Plan debates seem less repetitive, more information. There are true abstracts away from real policy discussion, the key to applying abstract principles, concrete action, risky education, and unresolved debates. To arbitrary outcomes, which excuse fairness, the A2s ask you their interval limits of variety of average kills, feel the affluence against the dozen connect strategy, the 80% two on the topic according to the view really means that the interval that equalizes you are the best. G, plan force negatives of research to mystical answer results that gravity also promotes research skills, which are always they have since it's any career should promote all forms of education debates under the interval reach be the gym general ground, whereas mind access and breadth and depth. Also, on the that's fine, on the voter, also, education and impact, because the only reason that school is funded in the first place, which means that both should be relevant when it can happen in the 2NR and the 2AR, but also exclusion of background is inevitable. The whole res asks you studies for specific countries, and they will exclude other next studies, planes that hold the have to be stable advocacy, whereas the whole res will ship it out of the country, specifically in the 1AR that ways it destroys on the ground. Also, that's fine. On your RVR roommates, you say that the app has the burden to be topical and you don't have the jurisdiction to vote on a non-topical app. RVIs don't make sense about you, but that doesn't that just says that I'm not topical, you should vote me down. It doesn't say that it doesn't make sense. My argument is that you skewed my 1 year attempt, so I should be I can't ever come back for that. The second argument was that you say bad tea should be able to be easy, but good reason to check the train trade off. But no, I have to overcome the time because that's the only reason I can collapse. Then your third argument is that it's reciprocal. You could I could run through, but you can see the argument, you can cross by there. You say RV is just add another later debate. The has to win, but no, the actual argument about the collapse that you can't cross by here. Then also, you say there's a chilling effect, but chilling effect doesn't make any sense because RVI is chill, because otherwise we need to check back frivolous theory, which this argument is because it's just about textuality. And like on your shell, all my arguments are always because your argument's about textuality, but that is I think to education, it's just a concrete thing, so it's not an issue about the actual fairness of the radical. All my arguments are only on an issue of the fairness because you say you can't overcome it. The disclosing on the wiki solves all of your offense because I've literally been reading this since round one of Loyola. I've not changed the affirmative at all, which means you definitely have the ability. The wiki argument solves all of your arguments and all your arguments around ground are just in terms of fairness, but no, you definitely have the other words, it's counter words because there's just two ships passing in the night, which means that we never can have debates. The app has to tie itself to a specific advocacy.
Cool. How much time do
we
have?
I'm sorry. Okay.
250. Did you read this before this A turns your inclusion arguments?
I don't think so.
Okay.
No, I did not. I just went the other way.
sorry. The part where you said fairness, that was a critique on the app. Then the K counterinterpret.
So fairness always the K first?
Yeah. Well, it's going to be overview. Then the fairness always the K. Then the, wait. So
I flow, where did you flow fairness always the K? I flowed on
yeah.
theory.
Where did you flow that?
Under view. It's fine. I'll find it.
Okay. All right. Fairness always the K. Then the critique. Topicality. All right. My intern, his intern.
You need to repeat that order.
Yeah. So, fairness always the K. Then the critique. Then the topicality. Then the urine trip.
Fairness always the critique. The critique. Then topicality. Urine trip.
Then no, urine trip.
Well, urine trip meaning, yeah.
Yeah.
Trip.
Yeah.
Are you reading new stuff?
What? No.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yep.
Yep.
He says fairness outweighs the K. The Galloway evidence says the opposition is key to dialogue, which turns all of his offense, because we need to be able to contest the assumptions that the affirmative makes, or rather that Jonas made in the 1NC before we can question things like fairness. It's a question of substantive fairness and procedural fairness. You should not prefer, you should prefer substantive fairness first, because we will never be able to question fairness in the real world, i.e. that non-humans are always excluded from our discussions in the first place. This is the better form of fairness, because it allows us to question the fairness in the real world. That's the only real world implication from this round. Turns all of his real world education argument. Second argument is that you don't get access to fairness outweighs the because it's not that the argument is not that your plan was in the percentage, but rather that you were in the percentage, your representation of the adolescent within the percentage, because you presume that it can only be human. When I asked you in cross-examination what an adolescent or whether you defended all adolescents, you said yes, I defend all adolescents, but you couldn't give a reason as why you defended the non-human adolescent, which clearly proves that you thought the adolescent within the percentage in the first place. Now you say that there's a 4 minute 1 hour, which means that I need to collapse something. First argument is that you can just answer both the critique and the topicality, which you did not do. Clearly you had pre-written shells, which clearly proves that you could have done both. Now, you also say that I can't do weighing between the two, but there's no more as to why this is true. You could have just done more weighing as to why theory of topicality comes before the critique. Also, hard debate is good debate. Given that fairness is just an internal link to fairness, you should have a high threshold for giving for topicality before critique. Also, if I win the critique outweighs in terms of education, then you should vote for me now. Now go to the critique. Extend the Colebrook 14 evidence, which indicates that if there was any value in humanity, if there was any value in humanity in the first place, that has been lost, given the fact that we have destroyed the non-human over and over again. Humanity is founded upon the disavowal of non-human populations. We exclude them over and over again. That's Colebrook 14 evidence, which indicates that the role of the valid is in the producer determining the moral standing of humanity. He did absolutely no weighing between the role of the valid and the affirmative. You should prefer the role of the valid over the topicality argument that he's making, because it's a question of whether we can. It's a question of education for who? He's only giving education for humans, but I am saying prior to that question, we should determine the moral standing of humanity. He's conceding that the moral standing of humanity is negative, meaning that none of these education or fairness claims matter. He's also conceding the Goldman 12 evidence, which indicates that adolescence is a concept that extends across the non-human here world. We are a critique of him, not his plan, which means that none of his plain good arguments actually apply. Now, extend the Cheney 05 evidence, which indicates the alternative is for the judge to vote negative, to reject the anthropocentrism of what Jonas did in the 1AC. Now, the role of the judge to use the base case as a practice of post-humanity as an already displacing anthropocentrism, because a empirical parochialism, which only takes into account anthropocentric views of the world, takes away from education, because anthropocentrism is a very limited worldview. We will never be able to take into account the non-human. He's conceded that the alternative is not a policy, because the critique is a criticism of the mindset of Yav, which means that I waste all of his arguments, because you should vote him down in order for them to not be anthropocentric out of the round. This is the only portable imagine made. He's done absolutely no way in between now why his specific education is unique to this round. Only the anthro education is unique to this round, because we are questioning the assumption that that he makes in the first place. Now, go to the interpretation. Extend the interpretation. The affirmative is a general principle that adolescents ought to have the right to make autonomous medical choices without specification. Clarify, you could have read your affirmative as a specific medical advantage, yeah, but you did not extend the violation that they only defend the affirmative for one specific medical choice. Now, extend the Nebel 14 evidence, which indicates that the bare plural adolescence and medical choice is generic as opposed to existential, meaning that you cannot specify one specific medical choice, because the resolution is referencing a general principle. You've conceded that the reason that topicality is important is because it is the only thing that we have going into the round. The only thing that we have going before the round is the text of the resolution, meaning that I cannot predict anything that you could have read. You said disclosing solves all your ground arguments. Well, first, the wiki was down, meaning that I could not have access to any of your access to any of your affirmative. But also, it's a question of what type of ground. There is very bad ground that I'm getting here. Yes, I can get ground if you disclose, but it's very bad ground. I.e., if you defended affirmative that only defended the specific medical choice of harmless surgery for black disabled children, I obviously wouldn't be able to get any ground on that, even if you disclosed it. Now you can see the Harris 13 evidence indicates that you overlimit by restricting debate to one issue. There are literally thousands of medical choices, which means that limits are a real impact because I feel their impact every day. He isn't on any way as to why he has any portable impacts in this round, but limits is a portable impact because it's a question of what the affirmative justifies. He justifies limiting to one specific issue, which means that we will never be able to do anything outside the round absent debate, which means that we will never be able to discuss real issues in the real world because we're just prepping out debate affirmatives. You conceded the ground standard, which means that topic literature always flows affirmative because very few authors will talk about why his specific affirmative is bad, only in general, meaning that I don't have access to a wide body of offense, which puts him at a structural advantage. It also solves his time skew argument, because if I'm at a structural advantage, then your time skew argument doesn't even make sense, because I couldn't have access to your affirmative in the first place. You conceded the voter's fairness, you're about to ask the voter rating, which you can't evaluate if one debate or structural advantage. Now, fairness is a prerequisite. If debate wasn't fair, no one to participate. Participation is a prerequisite to education being gained. Second, education is not unique. We all wanted to learn from the library. Third, my form of education outweighs because it's specific to this debate round, because anthropocentrism is only something that he did within this debate round, but we can always get his education in other debate rounds. Also, turn,
I'll give him an RBI. Now I'm going to the interpretation.
The interpretation was that... The interpretation was that if after defend must defend that a government or group of governments implements a policy that gives adolescents a right to make autonomous medical choices, but you don't meet the interpretation. You didn't make an IME. You don't defend all adolescents. You only defend human adolescents, meaning that given that you said adolescents is all adolescents across contamination, you don't actually meet your interpretation now. You say planes are key to appearances is clear to good judging, but this presumes that pragmatic justification comes first. You can see a semantic sum first because absent semantic justifications, I can never access the pragmatic justifications of the plan, given that I couldn't contest in the first place, which means that we will never be able to determine whether the app is true or. You can see that a topical version of your app solves all of your offense, given that if you had read this as a topical version of the app, then we could have engaged in substantive debate, which turns all of your education claims, because we could have engaged in a substantive level of the affirmative, given that the only defendant is physical medical choice, then we will never be able to debate the affirmative.
It's a very clear round. The role of the ballot comes first. We have to determine the moral standing of humanity, and given that all of his education claims are things about why planes are good and things about how we need education for real-world skills, these things only apply to human. He didn't answer the critique, and there's no new arguments as to why topicality comes first. And I only have contextualized education for Globex.
Alright, I don't need the phone. But,
no.
That's mine. What did I say you have?
104. Oh, your arguments about not all adolescents, I don't mean by inter, what was that argument? Where was that?
So, in cross-examination, you said that you defended all adolescents, but you conceded that your plan only applies to human adolescents, meaning that you do not give adolescents the right to make autonomous medical choices, you only give human adolescents the right to make autonomous medical choices. Okay. Because in cross-ex, you said, I defend all, or you said that.
Order is going to be starting on the 1AC underview, then the your interp, my interp. Oh, the very top is the fairness before education debate. I had that float on theory, so wherever you have that float. So fairness before education, then the, it'll be an overview of the round that you don't have to flow. Fairness before the critique, then the, fairness before the critique, and then you can go his interp, my interp. After the 1AC overview. Sorry, okay, that still sounds messy.
Okay.
Does that make sense? Okay, fairness before the K. Then the 1AC interview, then the his interp, my interp.
Fairness before the K. It'll be like an overview and then on fairness before the K.
Okay.
Okay. Ready? Yeah. Lolo Bob, easiest decision ever. If you think I'm winning fairness before the K, I win. You've conceded the extension of reasonability out of the 1AC at the end, which means that if you're not extending any reason for competing interpretations, I'm only extending reasonability in the 1AR, which means literally all I have to do is meet my bright line, which I definitely have, and I even accept that in the 1AR, which means that if you've conceded, I get the RVI, which means that if you're using a reasonability paradigm, you've made no reasons why competing interpretations is the only way I can get an RVI. So at that point, it's game over. You give me the RVI if I win fairness before the K. All right. First, extend that fairness top Cali's reason to prerequisite to any form of discussion turns all your creative packs. That's the Galway evidence that I don't even understand your answer. Call for the Galway evidence. You have debated the college policy for 3 years. You obviously know it's not a bad procedural discussion. I'll get your arguments. He talked about how courting fairness, but the one is excludes the other. It denies the person over the other because backed by research and critical thinking, unable to participate in dialogue. That's exactly my argument about how fairness is not always going to be an issue because if that route was unfair in the first place, then I can never engage in the criticism because that was my argument, especially. I can never. So I guess I'll go to your. He talked about how opposition is necessary, but that's not his argument. His argument is to reach an agreement which binds us to common causes. We need to have equality for the sake of conversation. So in order for us to ever be able to discuss the critical implications of this criticism, we need to have fairness in the round because otherwise two to not agree for the dialogue to skepticism. The top guy if you do not respond to the warrant, prefer Galway because he's a carded author who debated in policy and coach policy for over 50 years versus Saavan Nanavati, who is a 16-year-old in high school, probably always on specificity, but then go to your arguments. First, you say that you need to be able to contest the assumptions before Galway, but no, we are ultimately winning this argument. My argument is that I need to be able to answer your arguments, which I definitely can't do if I'm skewed in the first place, which means that if especially at the point where you're giving the RVI, it's necessary in order for fairness to be able to have to go first. And you say that non-humans are always excluded, but I could never have even contested the anthropocentrism K before. That was the internal warrant of the argument, which means that I could never contest it, especially when you be able to switch your time, which is always going to put me at a disadvantage. Then you say real world education, that you say I was answering all these arguments. You say the K is important. None of them are reasons why the K has to come before fairness necessarily. And you say that real world education is going to matter more because in terms of the real world, the fact that I could never contest the criticism. This is the overview that applies to all of your arguments, but also you say I was anthropocentric, but that assumes that I can respond to the link, which you said I could have. If I just spent my time more efficiently, but you're like, he's not actually making any reasons why the critique outweighs fairness. But even so, he just says he's anthropocentrist, and I can't protect myself. But the argument is that, like, it's like fairness comes before the critique. Prefer Galway over Saavan, is like Galway's carded, and he's like, he's chill. Then, when I see interview, extend that the extend reasonability that the affirmative should prefer reasonability. You're using your bright line of impact turn and link turn ground, which 100% conceded that you could have impact turned because you could have said the state is bad by reading a Wilderson critique or link turn by saying that people can't afford it or something. That was exactly your dissent that you read that was specific to the affirmative about how hormone blockers could potentially be expensive, which means you definitely made the reasonability bright line. I don't have to win the competing interpretation. 100% conceded extension of reasonability out of the last week's not a single word for competing interpretation being extended, which means that the reasonability bright line is extended. You can extend that. I get the RVI in order to check for this theory. You even said I get the RVI in the last week's we reached at that point. It's game over. But also that's fine. So basically, the round breaks down really easily. Your arguments are all just like the K is important, and I could have responded to both. Those are not weighing arguments. The argument is that you said I don't meet my intern, but that doesn't matter because of reasonability. But then other than that, it doesn't matter. I do meet my intern because it's like adolescence, but like fairness outweighs the K. Prefer Galway, reasonability. Okay, sure. Good.
Thank you.
Tuna are in a really good opportunity here because the app sets up a bunch of different layers that he has to win. He's got to win, you know, he's got to win this fairness versus roll the ballot stuff. He has to win the RVI. He has to win his counter-interpretation. But the Tuna, I think, probably stretched itself a little thin or misallocated. I was honestly really surprised when you only made two answers to Galloway because you start there and I'm like, awesome, you jump on Galloway and you win K first, you pretty much win the debate because it's his only, it's really his only reason why fairness comes before the K. So I don't know why this wasn't a much bigger part of the 2 and R. The only arguments you have against this piece of evidence are first, this concedes that K's are good because opposition is good. I kind of agree with the 2AR argument that K's might be good, but that fairness is a prerequisite to having a good K debate, that, yeah, okay, we can agree that questioning assumptions of, you know, non-human-human divide is a good idea, but the app has to be able to engage in that dialogue to get that education, which is what a lot of your 2NR impacts are premised on. So I think that you don't have a good kind of principled reason why your offense comes before fairness. This argument is tagged as a prerequisite in the 1AR, and so I think you have to deal with that quality, that function of the argument. All you've said is that, oh, this says opposition is good for dialogue. I provide opposition. Jonas is like, yeah, you do, but I cannot further oppose you because you have been unfair in this debate. The second argument you make is that you don't get access to this because it's not that the plan was anthropocentric, but you were anthropocentric. I don't know what the impact of that is or why, just because he is anthropocentric, that means fairness shouldn't matter or dialogue shouldn't matter. And those are the only two answers to Galloway. Now, there's some other things in the speech I look at. So I look at, okay, hard debate, good debate. It's really, the problem I have with that argument, also the fairness for whom that's somewhere else on the flow is, those are not directly responsive to Galloway, and they're really just taglines, the way they're explained in the 2 and R. You're just like, oh, fairness is only an internal link to fairness. Well, no, not the way he's explained it. It's a sequencing argument that fairness comes before all other types of education impacts and is an internal link to those. You say have a high threshold. Fine. That makes sense if I'm evaluating both fairness and education, but the 1AR has made a very clear fairness first argument that says I should not weigh the two against each other. There are some other arguments. There's some weighing on the T debate that you do, but most of that stuff is that is pretty much exclusively between your T interpretation and the counter interpretation, the type of education Anthro provides, and the type of education that the plan provides, not between fairness and the role of the ballot. Yeah, the very last thing in the 2NR, you extend the role of the ballot, and you're like, oh, the role of the ballot comes first because it's about not just education for humans, but understanding the standing of humanity vis-a-vis the non-human, and a different type of education, education for whom, right? I take that as more of a response to his education arguments. It's not tagged in terms of responding to fairness, but second, he does do weighing between role of the ballot and T. That is exactly what the Galloway evidence is doing in the 1AR. So I don't think that you have some unique access to weighing through the role of the ballot. Third, I think the Galloway is an internal link to this because if we want to get that education, then we should have a fair debate. Pretty simple argument, but not really handled very well in the 2NR. Then the second part of my decision is obviously he meets his reasonability bright line that was dropped in the 2NR.
Okay, how did you evaluate like substantive fairness before procedural fairness?
Yeah, so that's a part of your first response to the Galloway evidence. To be honest, you say prefer substantive fairness over a procedural form of fairness. I don't really understand why he is not substantive fairness in the way you mean it. You say, oh, because the way I understand it is, you say one type of fairness is the kind of fairness we're concerned with in the real world, that non-humans are excluded. But the way you get access to that offense, that we should care about that, is through the K, which Galloway is an internal link to. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I think you would have won this debate had you had five, six answers to this Galloway card and just really buckled down. The places you lost time were extending the K for too long. That stuff was dropped. You extended for like 10 seconds. I know you're trying to leverage more of it to take out plans good, but just win the T debate. Focus your effort there rather than these, you know, kind of questionable cross-ups out of the Anthro K. Obviously, dropping reasonability was a big problem, but like you could have won even that with this higher level framing. The two arrows was a smart strategy. I didn't think it was executed nearly as well as it could have been. So some of the stuff, like, you know, he does say the for whom argument, hard debate, good debate, those are things that you can answer even if they're not impacted very well. You're a little repetitive in the 2AR, like you make this Galloway's cool, better than you, expert argument twice. It's a bad argument, no need to make it more than once. Deal with this procedural thing more head on. I know you say something in response to it, but it was pretty blippy, not very big. You probably spend too much time extending that you meet your reasonability bright line at the point that it's conceded in your overview. Your overview was like 30 seconds long, way too long for a 2AR, especially given the simplicity of this 2AR. All you needed to say was, I win reasonability, he dropped it. If I prove I'm reasonable, I win an RVI. That impacts the fairness. So if I have fairness before the K, I win. That probably took like 6 seconds to say. And then you've got a bunch more time just to play out some more warrants. Same thing as the 2NR. Just sit on this Galloway evidence and, you know, instead of having three responses to his number one, let's have six or seven and just go all in. I don't really have any other advice. The 1AR was, I don't know where you're losing time in the 1AR, but it, you know, you've got to get to this semantic stuff. Like, you were probably going to lose this T debate on its own merits just by conceding, like, you are not topical. Their impacts from topicality are impacts to this. Your counterinterp does not prove that you are topical because it only proves that you're pragmatically good. That kind of framing argument is in the initial shell and something you, like, if you don't deal with, you're probably going to lose this debate.
What do you think a good answer to that is? Does your article not, like,
the most
answer arguments?
The most recent article that John and I wrote explicitly deals with these arguments.
Okay. How about look at that?
Yeah.
Thanks for joining.
Yep, good to meet y'all.
Oh.